I get that. Even as we speak, I am told that Mitt Romney just said that yesterday the general election begins, David, and at a fundraiser last night, here's what the president had to say, sort of setting up the general election.
That's the choice in this election. This is not just your run-of-the-mill political debate. We have not seen a contrast like this in a long time. This is the defining issue of our time, this make-or-break moment for our middle class.
Well, historians are going to love this one because then at another event, he compared this race to Johnson Goldwater, which, of course, ended up in the biggest Democratic landslide in history. But I'm told that Mitt Romney just said, oh, no, that's not it. It's more like Carter Reagan. How do you see this race shaping up, David?
Well, I think over the past couple of days, and I'll let Mitt Romney and President Obama fight out whether it's Goldwater Johnson or Carter Reagan, and I think both could probably make a case there. But I think we've seen in speeches and remarks from both the president and the governor over the past couple of days how they want to frame this election. Mitt Romney wants it to be about economic opportunity for everybody. Some will succeed, some will fail, but everybody will have the freedom to pursue the dreams that they want. The president is arguing for economic fairness so that everybody has a fair shot. Everybody's protected by the government if they have a run of bad luck. Both of these messages have an opportunity to resonate with voters. Neither should be dismissed or discounted by the opposition. But it does set up a contrast, as the president said and as Mitt Romney has said. And I think that's what could make this election very interesting, is that the candidates are offering really starkly different visions. And it may just come down to independent voters. Some recent polls have shown that Romney's message resonates better with independents than the president's, but I don't think we can say at this point how this is going to go.
And one of the things, obviously, that the president is looking at very strongly, and he's going to be talking very shortly at the White House, the Buffett rule. We're going to be hearing about this all week long. It is about tax fairness, about economic fairness.
Yes, and Mitt Romney is the poster person for this. You know, he is the example. We forgot about the Occupy Wall Street movement. Mitt Romney is the 1%, and I think the president
should say that it's going to be interesting. Behind the president today is going to be people who make $1 million a year and their secretaries. And presumably their secretaries are paying at a higher tax rate than those millionaires are, in the same way that they're going to point to Mitt Romney with, what, 15-16% tax rate.
Yeah. It's perfect for the president's argument to have Mitt Romney as that candidate, because they just put a big bullseye around him and say this is the problem.
All right, Karen Hunter, David Drucker, and we are waiting for the president. Thanks to both of you, and of course to Richard Land as well. We do want to get you caught.